Hello, dear students. Welcome to this presentation. Today we are going to talk about parallel structure. Okay, writers use parallel structure when they join two or three words or phrases of the same part of a speech together in sentences. Those parts of a speech could include nouns, verbs, adjectives, adverbs, and other parts of a speech. Parallel structure is necessary because using this kind of structure, the writers can have the same pattern of words in order to express two or more ideas in the same sentence. And they also express that those ideas have the same level of importance or the same weight of importance. We join parallel structures with the use of coordinating conjunctions such as or, and. For example, we have here, I like fishing, hiking, and skating. As you can see, we have the verbs fishing, hiking, and skating. The three verbs are presented using ing form. So we have fishing, hiking, and skating. Here, it is not possible to say, I like fishing, hiking, and to skate, because we are using here the gerund form. So at the end, we couldn't change to the infinitive form. That's why to skate here wouldn't be correct. So this kind of parallel structure allows writers to express several ideas in one sentence. For example, I decided to get my own apartment and visit my parents once a week. In this case, in this example, I have get my own apartment and visit my parents. So we have here get and visit. So we have the verb in the same form. Other examples include more than three ideas together in the same sentence. For example, when I explained my reasons, my parents listened. This is the first idea. Then, when I expressed my love, my parents listened. And then, when I promised to stay in touch, my parents listened. So I have three separate ideas, but I can join or combine them in one sentence if I use parallel structure. So if I want to combine those ideas, I can say, when I explain my reasons, express my love, and promise to stay in touch, my parents listened. So I have three sentences, three ideas expressed in one. When I explain my reasons, comma, express my love, comma, and promise to stay in touch, my parents listened. Other examples here, we have Rio is well known for lovely beaches. Rio is well known for exciting nightlife. So we have here two reasons why Rio is well known. So, for lovely beaches is the first reason, and then we have for exciting nightlife. I can combine the two sentences in one using parallel structure, and I can say Rio is well known for lovely beaches and exciting nightlife. So, in this way, we demonstrate that repetition of some words is not necessary when we use parallel structure appropriately. And I have another example. I clearly explained my reasons. I strongly expressed my love. So as you can see here, we have two ideas combined in one sentence. We have explained, expressed. Clearly explained, strongly expressed. We have the same pattern because we have here an adverb plus a verb in the past tense. And the same here, an adverb plus a verb in the past tense. In the first case, we have lovely beaches, exciting nightlife. We have an adjective plus a noun. And again, we have an adjective which is exciting plus a noun which is nightlife. So in this way, we are using parallel structure appropriately. Okay, remember that you can avoid repetition when you use parallel structure. So in this way, your writing will be more interesting and it will be easier for your reader to enjoy it in order, and you will avoid repetition and your reader will not be bored. Then it is also a good way to combine ideas. You can combine ideas, different ideas, in one sentence. A very important point is to remember that similar parts of a speech can be grouped together. You can group nouns, you can group infinitives, gerunds, verbs in the past tense, an adverb plus a verb in present or past tense. So it is important to have the same parts of a speech combined or grouped together. So in this way, you will be using this parallel structure adequately. Okay, thank you very much, and I hope we can talk about other topics next time. Thank you very much.